Thomas, also Lizasaurus, on the Instagrams. I'm going to teach you how to do a drop knee start on the slackline. So this particular slackline, it's 1 inch wide. It's Tantalus by Slacklife BC. Holla! You can do this kind of start on a 2 inch wide line, a 1 inch. It doesn't really matter the size. You can do it on a chain. You can do all the starts on anything, basically. This is just what I have here today. But with a drop knee start, you sit on the line, and I'm on like my left butt cheek right now, and then I have my left like ankle on the line. I pick up my right foot, and so it's almost like you're in a cross-legged position, but instead I'm gonna put my right foot pointing towards my anchor. It's parallel to the line. My shoulders are square, I'm looking forward, and you're going to rock forward, put it like displacing your weight evenly between like the shin ankle area and your foot. And just to like really show this, like this is kind of how it looks from my angle. I'm not on the top of my foot, I'm not over here. I have my foot on the other side of the line and it's like on my ankle shin area. And then I'm on the same butt cheek. So left butt cheek, left shin ankle, right foot is parallel to the line. I look forward and then I'm gonna rock, displacing my weight evenly between my shin and my foot. You can stay here. You can also even like actually fully sit, but just stay here where you're kind of sitting on your ankle and then stand. And you can keep contact with the line through the whole stand, and I'm still pushing into the line with my ankle shin area. And then you can flip that foot to come to a full stand on the slack line. You can also do that really quickly when you start getting more comfortable with it. You come here and you stand, and I'm pretty much like half pistol squatting the top of that stand. It's all on my right foot, and then I place my left foot on the line. And then you can start walking. So those are two different options. They're very similar, they just have subtle differences. With that, you can also, when you start getting more comfortable, you don't even have to pause in the drop knee, which is why it's called a drop knee start. You can actually just like do it in one continuous motion where you almost skip the drop knee and you're just using that shin ankle area to push you up into your stand. I love this start. I think it's great. It's really useful for a lot of lines, but in general, I think it's way more stable to do a sit start because you do have that loss of contact from your shin to the pad of your foot. And so you just have to be really comfortable with that range of motion. But if you are, like, do it. This was the original way that I mounted highlines. I like only did this and then I converted to the sit start. So do that on both sides. So on the other side, I'm gonna sit on my right butt cheek. I got my right shin ankle on the line. I got my left foot a comfortable distance in front of me. Don't want it too close because I need room for this. I don't want it too far because that's like really far to get to. Just like right there. It's actually pretty much in line with my knee, but it might be slightly different for everybody. I rock forward. My weight's even between my shin. And right now I'm actually flexing to keep the line in that spot. You don't have to do that, but you might end up slipping. So you can flex that back foot and then stand up and put your weight on the pad of your foot. And there's always gonna be that like moment of airborneness where you're only on your front leg. So obviously, well, maybe not so obvious, but with this start, when you stand, the weight is not even when you stand. It's mostly your front foot and your back foot. You are pushing down on it, there is pressure, but it's mostly for balance than to actually get up because you're practically doing a pistol squat. So, oh, I just did a sit start, I'm sorry. Another way to do this one is you can use the top of your foot instead of your ankle shin. So I start with that cross-legged position. I have my right foot forward and come comfortable distance ahead, I can actually go to a full drop meet. I can like push that, I kind of wiggle around a little bit to get my left butt cheek on the line. And I'm also, I think I'm still inside my sit bone, and now I'm on the top of my back foot. And this is a really great stretch. I totally recommend it, it's really awesome. But I'm doing a half flexed foot. You can see it's pretty straight, but my toes are flexed, and that's how I'm keeping my foot on the line. One problem with this is eventually it really beats up your skin. Also with just a normal drop knee, it really beats up the skin on your ankle shin area. It gets really raw. I have it on the top of my foot, and I can stand from here. I think this gets you a little higher. Like I have a fully straight right leg, and my left leg is still, or the foot is still on the line. I don't have that airborne time from here to here because I'm still connected to the line on my back foot with those toes in the top of my foot. You might have it on like the super top of your foot, and then you'll end up having that airborne time, but you're just eventually gonna skin your foot. It's gonna be fine. But that's also a really secure way to sit down, is you can go to the drop knee and then you can push it back. And that is how to do the drop knee start on a slack line using your ankle and shin, and also using the top of your foot. And eventually, if you want to get into the splits, this is a pretty prime way to get into the splits, but that'll be later. Ta-da! Yeah. There are quite a few people who do use that mount on a high line, but it's more rare. The most people use the chongo, and probably a little bit less than that use the sit start, and maybe a little bit less than that use the drop knee start. Yeah, thank you for watching my video. If you liked it and you want to learn more how-to slackline tutorials, please follow my channel and subscribe. If you have any questions, please put them in the comment box below. Thank you.